everybody, and welcome to a workshop from Kilkenny Libraries for the National Keep Well campaign. My name is Alan Nolan, and I'm an illustrator and I'm a writer. And I write and I draw books for children, but I'm especially interested in comics. I've always loved comics. I've been a big comic fan since I was really small. I used to read comics when I was a kid, like the Beano and like the Dandy and 2000 AD and Whizzer and Chips and Whoopi. And do you know what? I even love comics so much. I'd read all the girls' comics that my granny, Nanny Gig, would bring home for my sister. And they'd have names like Bunty and Jinty and Jackie and Judy and Tammy and Mandy and stuff like that. But I loved reading comics. I didn't mind what I read at all. But my favourite comics when I was a kid were definitely superhero comics. And this comic here is the first comic that I ever bought with my own money. It's a Spider-Man comic, and it's Spider-Man and Werewolf. It's a Marvel team up, and it was really, really cool. And I used to learn how to draw by looking at all the pictures in this one comic that I had, because American comics, US comics, are really hard to come by in Ireland when I was a kid. There was no Forbidden Planet and no Big Bang and no Subsidy and no comic shops anywhere in the whole of Ireland. So you used to have to wait, and hopefully one of these comics would turn up in the newsagent at some stage. And I think I got this one in Kerry when I was on holidays when I was a kid. But I learned how to draw by copying all the pictures of Spider-Man, and there was a bad guy called Tatterdemalion. He's that hobo guy who's up there. I used to draw them the whole time when I was a kid. So I love drawing, and I love superheroes because of that. Yeah. But I loved other comics as well. I loved the American comics like Avengers and like Batman and Superman. Hulk was a favourite. I have an old Hulk comic. It's upside down. I have an old Hulk comic that I had when I was a kid right here as well. I loved DC superheroes. I love Marvel superheroes. I love the costumes that they have. Remember, Spider-Man has such a good costume. You know, his origin story was he was bitten by a spider when he was a teenager. He was out somewhere taking photos, because his real name is Peter Parker, and he was bitten by a spider when he was out taking photos at a science experiment in a laboratory, and the radioactive spider bit him, and he got all these spider powers, and he was able to climb up walls, and he was able to shoot webs out of his wrist, and he wore this kind of costume with a big hood so you couldn't see his face, and a big red and blue, like a red and blue dangerous kind of almost like an Australian spider, head to toe, with a kind of web thing on it and a logo of a spider in the middle. Batman as well is cool. His origin story was when he was a kid, he fell into a cave. And when he got into the cave, it was pitch dark and there was loads and loads of bats everywhere, and they scared the bejapers out of him. So when he came out of the cave, he got himself out. And even though he was a kid, he said, "I'm going to fight crime when I get older. I'm going to dress as a bat because they frighten me. Imagine how much they frighten criminals." So he dresses as a bat with the big bat ears and the big bat cape that looks like bat's wings when he's jumping around the place. And he has a bat symbol on his chest and kind of these kind of spiky bat things on his gloves. He looks really cool. So that's what we're going today. We are going to design our own superhero. So all you will need to design your own superhero is this superhero sheet. Or if you don't have one of the sheets, you can just do it on a blank piece of paper. But I've done these sheets specially for designing superheroes, and they're a great help to me when I'm designing characters. Now, I have a few little prompts here. First of all, the box is you have to choose your superhero name. So you think of a superhero name, and then you choose your superhero power. So what's the power? They could fly, I have a few suggestions coming up in a few minutes, don't worry about that. And you have to choose their origin story. So I have written down here, as a child was bitten by a radioactive dot, dot, dot. And this is a bit like Spider-Man's bitten by a radioactive spider. You have to decide how your superhero became a superhero. So first of all, we'll do a bit of work on the character name. So I have a few little suggestions here as to what you could name your superhero character. So what I usually do is I take something from column A and add it to something from column B, or something from column B and add it to something from column A. And these are just suggestions. You don't have to go with any of them. So I have loads of names here that you can choose from. In fact, you don't even have to choose these. You can make up your own. But in column one, in the first column there, we have words like captain, hamster, otter, gerbil, mister, lord, monkey, atomic, doctor. And in column two, you could have things like boy, man, gent, lady, accident, dilemma, woman, teen, Ireland, cop, victorious. And the idea is that you take one for column one and one for column two and mix them together or vice versa. So you could have Captain Accident, who's this crazy sort of like Captain America, except instead of being really cool, he has an accident the whole time. He either trips up, but maybe he trips up and falls down the ground and the bank robbers trip over him. So maybe that's how he solves crimes. You could have Lord Victorious. He actually sounds like a supervillain, which you could do a supervillain as well. You can have Atomic Lady, who when she gets annoyed, she blows her top and there's like a nuclear explosion comes out of her and everybody's blown away by her. So you can mix and match. And remember, they don't have to be those. They could be something a little bit similar or totally different. It's totally up to you. There's no right way or wrong way to do this. Now, for the superhero power. All superheroes have a superhero power, apart from Batman. And his superhero power is he's a billionaire. So he can make all these gadgets to solve crimes, solve mysteries, and catch robbers and catch murderers with. But normally, superheroes will have superpowers that they get from, well, we'll talk about the origin in a sec. But some of the superpowers that you could have for your superhero could be they could shoot lasers from their eyes. They could have the loudest burps, like earth-shattering burps. Big earthquakes happen when they burp. They could have unusually large feet for stamping out crime, obviously. They can change TV channel with their mind. They could creep up. Imagine you could do that. You could creep in and when somebody's watching TV, your brother or sister, and they're watching something really cool, you could go and just put on the news. And they go, who put on the news? J.D. Mac. They could fly like Superman. They could jump like a flea. And I don't mean like, like a tiny flea. I mean, think about how small a flea is and how far they can jump. They could jump all the way from Kilkenny to Bray. That's how far they could jump. They could have the smelliest farts, which would be a really bad... Actually, I don't know whether that's a good superpower or a bad one. They could make rain. They could control insects like Ant-Man. Or they could eat anything. And when I say anything, I mean anything. I once read about this guy in America who ate a whole aeroplane. Like, not a big jumbo jet, like a tiny two-seater plane. But he ate everything, all the bits of metal, and broke it up and ate every little nut and bolt and every ground up the glass and ate it. Really dangerous. He must have a stomach made of metal. But he was able to eat the whole thing. I don't think he felt very well after it. Okay, and then finally, for your superhero, you have your name, you have your powers. How do they become a superhero? You need an origin story. So I have, as a child, was bitten by a radioactive dot, dot, dot. And it could be a radioactive guinea pig, a radioactive school principal, a radioactive traffic warden, a radioactive caterpillar, a radioactive lollipop lady, which would be terrible because lollipop ladies are all lovely, a radioactive potato. So if you had Captain Ireland, they could have been, I was bitten by a radioactive potato, tiddly tiddly, ho ho. They could be bitten by a radioactive burger maker at McDonald's, or even a radioactive hippopotamus. So that's what you have to do. You have to think of your superhero name, you have to think of your superhero power, and you have to think, as a child, was bitten by a radioactive, you have to think of your superhero origin. So when you're drawing, and I want you guys to draw on the favourite superhero sheet or just on a piece of paper if you don't have one, but you have to think about what your superhero name is. So I'm going to do this with you, right? I'm going to design off the top of my head an absolutely cool, or maybe not so cool, superhero. So I'm going to go superhero name. I will go with, let's see, I'll go with Captain because I love Captain America. So I'll go Captain. And maybe my favourite kind of monkey or ape is a chimp. So we'll go Captain Chimp. Captain Chimp. Absolutely brilliant because he sounds like Captain Champ. Okay, and superhero power. Well, he's a chimp. So chimps kind of swing from trees. He's got super swinging powers. So he's brilliant at swinging. And he could have super chimp strength as well, because they've got those feet that look like toes, and they've got their arms, and they're really strong. So strong as well. So he's super swinger and super strength. And as a child was bitten by a radioactive, well, there's only one thing he can do with the chimp, has to be a banana. So he was bitten by a radioactive banana. So I am going to design on a piece of paper here a superhero called Captain Chimp, who is going to have swinging powers and super strength. And as a child, he was bitten by a radioactive banana. So let's get to work. Okay, so to draw Captain Chimp, my famous or soon to be famous superhero, I'm going to wear my animal drawing hat, because I always wear this when I'm drawing animals. So I'm just going to draw Captain Chimp just to show you how it's done. So his name is Captain Chimp. I'll write it up here. Captain Chimp. Captain Chimp. Excellent. And we will start off with his eyes. So just two round eyes, I guess, like this, kind of egg shapes, little pupils inside. And whenever you're drawing pupils, here's a great drawing tip. When you're drawing pupils, you see the way there's a little light up there and it puts a shine in my eye? That will really make your cartoon character jump into real life and really look real if you put a little sparkle in their eyes. So whenever you're drawing a little pupil in here that's black, leave a little bit white up the top right or left hand corner, and that'll make your character look kind of more real. Okay, now I'm going to draw a funny nose in this chimp, because chimps have kind of one nostril here and one nostril here when I'm drawing them. So I'm going to draw a couple of nostrils, one here and one here, and then a huge big smiley mouth going around like that. A little open mouth underneath it, just like this, like a chin coming around, maybe a few little wrinkles, because chimps have little wrinkles going down their mouth like that. He needs a hat, of course, because he is a captain, so I'll put a captain's hat on him, like the captain of a ship, or the captain of a, well, I suppose he could be an army captain as well. Put the top of the cap on as well, so a little bit coming down like that. Floppy bit at the side and up like that. There we are. So it looks like a captain's hat, the band's going around it. We'll put a logo on the cap, like a badge on the top of the cap. Just like a little, keep it simple, like a little C logo for captain and for chimp. So C for captain, C for chimp. Excellent. Little hairy sides of his head here. Maybe a couple of little ears. Just an ear there. And an ear over here. Excellent. And now we're going to design his costume. So I think I'll just give him a sort of jumper to start with, like superheroes always wear kind of lycra, kind of tight fitting things. But this is a chimp. He's kind of hairy. He doesn't want that too tight fitting. So he's just going to look like he's wearing a sort of what would you call it? Long sleeve T-shirt you get out of Pennies. So that's what he's wearing here. He's got long sleeve T-shirt. There we are, leave a little gap there. A little alarm coming around like this. There we are, excellent. Now, and we'll put the logo on his chest as well. So I'll repeat this logo, such as it is, because it's only a kind of letter C in a big circle. So I'll draw another big circle here, and I'll do a letter C inside it. So similar enough to the one up there, cool. And then, because he's so hairy, he's going to have kind of hair coming out of the sleeves of his Penny long sleeve T-shirt. So I'll draw a little bit of hair here, and a little bit of hair here. And then I'll draw his hands. So I'll give him long chimpy fingers. There we are, and a long chimpy thumb as well. And in this hand, I'll make him hold a banana. So I'll just put his kind of chimpy fist here and draw a banana. That's why I left that little gap, so I could draw a little banana in there. It's a little banana going down like that. Cool, so he's holding a banana. And now, this guy is swinging from tree to tree. He doesn't want long trousers. I'll give him a pair of shorts, because he doesn't want to get caught going from tree to tree. Might even give him kind of cargo kind of shorts like that. There we are. Excellent, with little pockets on the side. But Batman wears a big belt that has loads of pockets and little holders in it that he keeps his sort of explosives in one, and sort of not laughing gas, because that'd be the Joker, but sort of tear gas in another, which sounds terrible, but he needs it for getting the bad guys, and little shadow under there, and then his hairy legs coming down. So hairy. The hair at the bottom, same here, hairy leg, because all chimps have hairy legs. Down to here, the hair at the bottom, and then huge big toes, nearly bigger than his actual hands. So a toe at the back like a thumb, and three kind of finger-like toes at the front. Here we go, another one, and one last one. And there we go. That is how I would draw Captain Chimp. And his superpower is he's swinging from tree to tree. So if you want to, you can put a kind of little vine coming down like this. Once you get in the jungle, sort of leaves coming off it. Maybe that's something that he brings around with him, and he could throw it around even when he's flying around. He could be in Kilkenny Castle and he's throwing it up to the top of the battlements and he's swinging around Kilkenny Castle like that on a big vine. That'd be really cool. And we have the banana that is part of his origin story, because as a child, as a baby chimp, he was bitten by a radioactive banana. We'll actually make it a bit radioactive. We'll put kind of shine coming off it like that. So guys, when you're designing your own superhero, you think of your superhero name, take the craziest name you can, think of really funny powers your superhero can have, and then think of an origin story. So well done everybody, I'd love to see what you do. And thank you for listening today. This has been a workshop for Kilkenny Libraries. Thank you very much.